Have you heard of the People's Budget Review yet? No?
Actually, he's got the flyers right here.
Yeah. Okay. Well, hello there.
Hey, how's it going? Good to see you again. Good to see you again.
Oh, where's your
friend?
Your fiance?
Oh, she's not mine. Yeah. Go say hi. All right. So, this is an initiative, coalition of, you know, residents from neighborhood associations to advocacy groups to students to, essentially, we want to get the budgeting process in the minds of as many citizens as possible. We realize out of like 250,000 members, there's 250,000 citizens, there's less than a fraction of a percent of people that actually have a say in the process. So our hope, we've created a survey, so the objective is we can make it, and our hope is to get it in front of a minimum of 10,000 people before the budgeting process is finalized. So we got May and June for some budget summits at the city hosts. And the survey allows citizens to prioritize their city services, allows them to rank what they find important, and hopefully we can aggregate the data, bring it to city council, and show them this is, you know, what your city thinks the city should be doing. And, you know, in an ideal world, the city council has a budget that reflects the citizens' priorities pretty closely. And if it doesn't, then we have some real opportunity to say, hey, can you guys meet us somewhere in the middle, or, you know, take up the citizens' vision.
Good luck.
Yeah, exactly. And what we kind of...
Look at the pier thing.
Exactly. And, you know, that's an option. The pier, the police headquarters, this is all on the survey.
Yeah.
And another thing is, well, we've been forced into this false dichotomy to that the budget process boils down to cuts in services or increase in taxes, when that's not the case.
Yeah.
There are creative ways to raise revenue that don't necessarily impact taxes of individuals.
Yeah.
And there's also, you know, ways to adjust the millage rate to make it so where we pay the same amount as last year, because with the property values declining, we're paying less and less taxes each year, and obviously we need more services, we need to keep our services in. We hope to
have a website.
The peoplesbudgetreview.org.
Okay.
peoplesbudgetreview.org
okay.
is on there.
Yep.
And basically, it's going to be a 3-month-long grassroots campaign, and we're rolling it out this Monday on the steps of City Hall at 11 a.m. So we got press conferences at 11, and then we're going to do street corner interviews from 12 to 2.
Okay.
And then we're going to do neighborhood canvassing from 5 to 7. And I say it's an online survey, so we're going to be hitting neighborhoods for 3 months straight every weekend. We're going to be tabling at events at schools and getting as many people to have a say in the budget process as possible. In my ideal world...
Memory's running out. No.
In my ideal world, this becomes an annual process, and we move closer to institutionalizing the citizen's voice in the budget
process. Sounds good.
Thank you, man.
What's your name?
Christian Haas.
Nick Weathersby. Nice to meet you.